these kinds of results are always going to blow accounts no matter what. And so that's why I decided to create this video today on proper risk management so you can get a better idea of how to control and better prepare for your future. Because when it comes to trading in the Forex market, growing your account by more than 10% every single month is going to result in huge losses or blown accounts. And so that's what I'm gonna be talking about in the majority of this video today and give you a better idea of how to plan ahead so you can better prepare for your future. Risk management is one of the most challenging things to do successfully as a trader. When I started back 15 years ago, I didn't know where to start. I didn't know if I should hire a tutor for trading. I didn't know if I should purchase an algorithm or buy a trading system. I ended up doing pretty much all of those because I didn't really know what the best thing to do was. And we're in 2021 now, and there's way more information out there, and so it's a lot more confusing. There's tons of traders that talk about risk management, but nobody really is talking about what is the correct risk management. Why? And the reason why is because they're trying to make a sale off of you. And the more profit that they can show you that they've made, the more impressive that is, and the more likely you are to buy their system, their strategy, their signals. And it's this never-ending process. So in this video, or this portion, I'm gonna be pointing you in the right direction of where to start building a system and then also building a risk management system on top of that. So I specialize in MT4, MetaTrader 4, and I've been building indicators and algorithms in MetaTrader 4 for over 8 years now. And it's a really good place, open source. There's some flaws with it as well, but it's great for strategy building as well, because there are so many indicators and algorithms out there that you can use. And so a good place to start is forexmt4indicators.com. There are thousands of indicators for MT4 and MT5 that you can download here for free. And a good thing to do when you're seeking out good indicators for your trading system is to use the strategy tester like you see here. The strategy tester in MT4 allows you to backtest algorithms, robots, and indicators as well to show you if they are repainting. And repainting is a bad thing. You don't want an indicator repainted. It basically shows a signal on chart and then after a while it disappears. That is a really bad thing. You don't want that because it gives you a false signal which will likely lose because it was inaccurate. So you want to make sure that you backtest your indicators and spend the time to build and find these indicators that work best for your personality and for the risk management that you're trying to do. So this is a good place to start seeking out good indicators for your system. All right, so now we're on to the risk management portion. And risk management is probably more challenging than actually building out a trading system, because then you're at the point of actually entering and exiting trades. And risk management is tricky because there are basically three predictions that you are making every single time that you enter the market. The first one is the trade entry. That is a prediction because you're entering the trade and thinking that you're predicting that it will go in your intended direction, right? The second prediction is the take profit, right? That's the second one. And that one is a prediction as well. You're predicting that the market will hit a specific point and you'll be able to close out your trades for a realized profit. And the third one is the stop loss. The stop loss is another prediction, and you're predicting that the market won't hit a specific point in price. And so these are three predictions every single time that you enter the market. And I don't think that most people realize that, that they're making three predictions. And so I've realized that if I were to somehow remove some of these three predictions in my trading, that I would have a better chance at profiting over the long term. And it shows with my algorithms, and this is where I start to pull in the risk management idea. This is where I started building refined risk management type that was run by an algorithm so it could figure out the best way to really beat this market. And so I developed the Ranger, the Vigorous algorithm, and the Pinpoint algorithm that have very refined ways of approaching the market with risk. And they remove a good portion of those predictions, those three predictions that I was talking about. Most of the predictions that are removed with my algorithms are the stop loss and the entry point. I know, which just sounds pretty crazy, But entry point is a very difficult thing to get right because the market doesn't always react right on our entry point, right? And so I've been able to develop some risk management that has to do with grid trading techniques, which you can find in my previous videos. I talk a lot about grid trading that allow me to not be perfect on my entry and still come out with a profit. And removing the stop loss. I know removing the stop loss is kind of a bad word for a lot of traders, but if you remove the stop loss, you have to be very careful with how much risk you're using each trade and to pull it way, way, way down because you're not dealing with single orders anymore. You're dealing with with a grid trade system that doesn't use a stop loss. So you have to make sure that your risk is minimized on each position so you're not over-risking your account. It has to be very calculated with the approach here, otherwise you could blow your account. And that's why I've developed all of these algorithms that incorporate these risk management ideas that remove the almost two out of the three predictions. And that's why I've been a profitable trader for the last almost 2 years now. Proper backtesting is overlooked by the majority of traders. Some traders think that it's not even valuable because they think that discretionary trading is where the money's at. And I completely disagree because if you think about it, we backtest the previous data to see, to find patterns that have been successful. And we want to see if those, we're trying to find patterns that may be successful in the future. That's why backtesting is valuable. Most traders don't realize that longer backtesting is more beneficial. And so they think that sticking to 3 years is enough. It shows enough market cycles to really show the robustness of their strategy. This couldn't be more inaccurate because we're now in the 21st century and the market is changing on a daily basis. So we can't possibly predict that a 3 years of backtesting is going to be enough. And the problem here with 3 years of beyond 3 year backtesting is that it becomes more difficult past 3 years. The more backtesting history that you gather, the harder it is to find a successful pattern that is long-lasting. And this is something that I try, I've tried so hard and work so hard every single day still to build, because finding a system that has a long-lasting strategy that is able to backtest longer than 10 years is incredibly hard to find. That's why I've gone through over 250 different algorithms to find only around five or so that can backtest longer than 10 years. And it's just a really difficult thing to do, but it's not impossible. And if you guys know where to start and what to do, and that's what I'm talking about in this video, it can help you in your journey of building a strategy that lasts longer than 3 years in backtesting. And another good place or good tip is to not try to shoot for too much profit. And like I was mentioning earlier in this video, if you're trying to profit above 10%, you're likely going to blow your account, whether it's after a couple weeks of trading or a year or 2 years or something like that. It's important to try to stick to something that is consistent and that is conservative, because if you're shooting for too much, you will blow your account. So look at a profit range of around 3 to 5% when you're trying to backtest your strategy and see if it can be scaled up or even scaled down. And try to shoot for beyond the 5 year mark, and preferably longer than 10 years. Some of my algorithms, like my Vigorous algorithm, is able to backtest 21 years successfully, which is the longest I've been able to backtest pretty much any algorithm in my 15 years of trading. So I'm not gonna show you guys an image here that I kind of drew up. I'm not a very good writer, so hopefully you can kind of follow along with me here. So this image here is 14 years timeline for backtesting a strategy. And you can see the top one, it says good, underlined here, good. And the top line is safe, the bottom line is safe. And you can see the little graph here in between. It shows basically the drawdown of your strategy. So I'm starting here in the middle and the strategy goes up. It's hitting like maybe 10 or 15% drawdown right here. Then it goes down, it goes back to zero drawdown, goes up to like 3% drawdown. So you can kind of see that these lines up and down within these safe zones are showing the drawdown of your strategy. And you can see that there are 2 points in this good one up here that we got close to some pretty high drawdown. And this could be 30% drawdown or 50% drawdown, whatever you think is high drawdown for your strategy. And it also depends on how long your strategy was actually running for. So this is a 14-year timeline, and only two periods of high drawdown that hit in 14 years is really quite good. And if you can build a strategy that is capable of that, that means you have something really quite special in your hands. All right, so the one below, the bad. So this is a bad one. This is when we're starting out with zero drawdown here at the beginning, and then we go all the way up to beyond 50% drawdown. In this case, we're gonna just say this is like 60 or 70% drawdown up here, and we exceeded our safe zone. And then we went down back to zero drawdown, and then, you know, in between 10, 15%. And then we go down again into a 60 to 70% drawdown or higher. And this happens a lot within this strategy, the strategy tester here, or this back test that we ran for 14 years with this specific strategy. Now, this isn't my strategies or my algorithms. This is just an example of what a bad one looks like, because it's constantly hitting the peak drawdown over and over again, which means that its robustness is being tested over and over again, or too many times, meaning that it's likely overfit, and it's going to probably crash at some point, sooner rather than later. So it's important to find something that looks like here, over here, and the best idea. This is the best right here. This is what I'm always trying to build, and I've been able to succeed with the majority of my algorithms, and I'm constantly tweaking them to even get closer to this, what I'm going to show you right now. So this is the drawdown starting at, like, again, 0%, and then we're going in the 5, 10, 15, 20% area over and over again, but it's not peaking out at the 40, 50, 60% all the time. And this is actually what I've been able to do with my three algorithms just recently. I put all three of them on one account, optimized, so they don't exceed more than 20% drawdown. And so this is what I've been able to finally achieve with my trading in my personal accounts, in my trading in general. And this is how I approach my trading, is looking for a peak drawdown, running three different strategies on the same account, and minimizing the risk of each strategy, and still coming out with a profit of around 2 to upwards of 5% every single month. So if you can get your strategy to not have huge peak drawdown over the course of, say, 14 years of backtesting, then you're in really good hands, and that's what the goal is, and hopefully at some point you can do it. I've been able to do it after quite a long time, and knowing the best place to start and having some tips on where to start can always guide you and put you in the right direction. The last thing I wanted to talk about in this video is the Aussie Canadian dollar with the Ranger algorithm. So some people have been reporting blown accounts or losses in 2006, way back in 2006, which is the earliest data that we can really get for the Aussie Canadian dollar pair for MT4. So I'm gonna fill that in with a YouTube comment that you can see here. So this person writes, "I can really recommend these EAs from Ryan. They do work well." Somebody responded, "No, they don't. My team backtested these EAs. They effed up every time. It's super low risk, low rewards until you blow your account. Why you think he's selling this shit?" Okay, so this guy doesn't really know much about backtesting. He and his team, maybe he works for a company or something, but it's really unfortunate that he doesn't really know as much as he's saying he does when it comes to backtesting, because I've been doing this for a long time, and it's really important to really know what you're backtesting by doing a visual backtest, by doing backtesting over a long period of time, and looking at the trades where they're entered, where they exit, and to try to figure out why the algorithm is losing or why it's actually profiting as well. And so these things are really important to kind of decipher or to find out when testing a strategy. Okay, so here on AussieCAD, I'm looking at back in 2006, in November of 2006, and this is where some people are reporting some crashes happening. So you can see here that we're starting in November and it goes up, and then it falls back down. And the thing is that when it falls down, it actually exceeds the take profit point here. It exceeds it by quite a lot, by 27 or 28 pips to be exact, and it still doesn't take the profit here. And then further, it comes back into the take profit line here, and that's what this red line is. This is where all the trades are supposed to close out for realized profit. And it comes back and exceeds it by another 8 pips, and that it still doesn't close out. So this is a MetaTrader 4 issue that you're witnessing right here. It doesn't have anything to do with the spread, and you can see here that if I go to my tick data and I turn the spread from 1 to 3 pips all the way down to 0 pips, the thing, it still crashes in the same spot. And it has nothing to do with my algorithm. It's a MetaTrader 4 issue, and I believe that it's because of the early data all the way back in 2006. Could be because of swap fees, it could be because of spread, I don't know what it is, but the issue is very prominent here, and it still shows that my algorithm is profitable. Now, I was able to work with the data by downloading some data from a different place, and also it was able to close out the data that this profitable basket here just fine. But still, this is what some people I have been referring to, and it's something that I wanted to share with you guys. So in my data here, on my tick data here, I work with a variable spread, I work with slippage, I work with accurate execution as well, to represent the best I can live trading in the future. And that's the best way to approach backtesting when you're working with a strategy. Some of you are wondering, if you're such a successful trader, Ryan, why are you selling or giving out your algorithm to people? Because it doesn't make sense. People think that if you have a profitable strategy, then you should just keep it to yourself. Yeah, I know I'm a bit unusual in that respect, and that's something that I've questioned over the past almost 2 years now. Originally, I gave out early copies of my Ranger to about 13,000 people or even more, because I was so tired of everybody losing in this industry, and I thought I found something that was profitable and wanted to give it out to people. Eventually, I ended up modifying the strategy to make it even better and creating a few other algorithms on top of that to really create my responsible Forex trading business. And so that's where I am today. And you know, I am making enough money enough profit from my trading alone for a full-time income. And I don't really need my business to really stay afloat. But I actually like doing it right now. It's busy, I don't have a lot of time at the moment. And eventually I will stop selling my algorithms. Those that have them right now or purchased during that phase where I am giving it out to the public, they will continue to be able to use it. But any new customers later on may not have that opportunity. I will increase the price eventually, and I will likely stop selling as well. And this is something that's just part of my progression and part of how I plan to move in the future. Because, you know, things get busy, and having a customer base it can be tricky. But I like to continue to work with people and to make sure that they're profiting using my algorithms and trading mechanics like this. So I hope that answers your guys' question when it comes to the big idea of why is Ryan doing this if he's so successful. And it's because I choose to be. I choose this life right now, and I choose not to spend it driving Lamborghinis and buying expensive houses. I actually decide to do different things with my money, but I do have fun. You guys got to realize that I do have fun out there, and I'm going to be showing some more lifestyle things in the future to show you that, you know, I can't have some fun out there. It doesn't include buying a $100,000 Lamborghini that's just gonna sit in my parking, in the parking lot. So hopefully you guys can continue to enjoy my channel, and please give me a like and subscribe so I can continue growing. Thanks so much for watching, and see you on the next one.